Welcome to the Federal Bar Association's 2021 QTAM Conference preview videos, and we are joined by Erica Hitchens. Erica, you are moderating a panel on what makes a successful QTAM case. Give us a sense of your panel.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Scott, and I'm really looking forward to the panel. We will be talking about, you know, really, when the press release of an FCA settlement comes out, whether it's big or small, it always makes the matter seem so tidy, right? It's easy to think that the path is straightforward. The whistleblower might walk into a relator's counsel's office, put together a complaint, some documents, file it, off to the races, a few years later, resolution, all set, right? But as any of us who have practiced for a little while know, those straight arrow cases are few and far between, if ever. So in reality, only a minority of the cases, right, result in recoveries, and then even less so the big headline grabbing numbers that we all read about from time to time. So this panel is designed to address a couple of issues, right? So first, we recognize that success can be defined in many ways. And so we'll ask each of these panelists how they define a successful QTAM case. And I'm particularly interested to see if that view's changed over the course of their careers. And whether even the current pandemic has shifted their thinking in any way, short-term or long-term with respect to that. Then we'll jump into the more practical, right? We wanna give some practical advice, what these experienced counsel have gleaned over the years that can help folks on every aspect part of our bar, right? Relators, counsel, government counsel, defense counsel, to ensure that a good case actually gets across the finish line. We hope to have a mix of practical advice and conversation that you just can't have when you're mired in the details of a particular case, even if you have a good working relationship among all of the attorneys. So I know you've created an environment with this conference where that is the goal, and that's what we'll be aiming for.
So Erica, who's joining on the panel?
So I'll be moderating, and I'm joined by three fantastic counsel. First, we'll have Neely Ben-David, who is the Deputy Chief and Healthcare Fraud Coordinator in the Civil Division at the U.S. Attorney's Office in the Northern District of Georgia. She's out at the tip of the spear, right? Leading the investigations, often in conjunction with Maine Justice, but often on their own as a U.S. Attorney's Office. She's phenomenal and will be great to hear from. So next up, as another government panelist and a really unique contributor, I think, is Karen Glassman, Senior Counsel, Administrative and Civil Remedies Branch of the Office of Counsel to the Inspector General for HHS. And Karen is exceptionally knowledgeable and experienced. I've had the pleasure of working with her when I was in the government. She and her colleagues play critical roles in evaluating and settling QTAM matters. And finally, we'll have Mary Inman, who is a well-known and very experienced and successful Relators Counsel at the Constantine Cannon. And I think her perspective from the moment a relator walks in the door will be really interesting.
So if I'm in the audience, what are my takeaways maybe that I can maybe expect to take away from this panel?
Sure. Well, one thing that I think, as I said before, right, is some practical advice. And so some of it will be, you know, things to be on the lookout for, things to think about if you're putting together a case for filing, or you want to be helpful as a relator's counsel, let's say, to the government. But I think some of it will be more nuanced to kind of hopefully just learn from the experiences and have something that's embedded now in your brain so that if that situation arises, you'll be ready to jump if needed. But I think something that makes this panel different and unique maybe from others that we've heard before is actually Karen's presence, right? So is Office of Inspector General Counsel's presence on this panel. You know, I think folks are pretty familiar with the fact that the IGs are involved, right, in investigations. They're often the agents who are out pounding the streets or the phone lines, I guess, these days, interviewing witnesses, reviewing documents. And I think lawyers know that there's the lawyers at the counsel's offices that are weighing in on settlement decisions, often in the healthcare context, right? Corporate integrity agreements become critical during the process. But I wanted to highlight the fact that it's not just during settlement, it's particularly when you're dealing with HHS. If you've got a complex healthcare fraud scheme that's alleged, particularly one that implicates policy issues or kickback and stark provisions, OSIG, as they're called, where Karen works, has a role throughout the case. And in many respects, right, they're the subject matter experts. They're dealing with it on key TAMs across the country, but also in other contexts as well. So they may not be out in front. They may not be who you're talking to if you're either a defense counsel or a relators counsel throughout the process, at least not until settlement. But they're playing an important role. And so I think people should be listening to what Karen has to say. And hopefully we'll see more folks from her office out at other panels as well.
Erica Hitchings, thank you so much. And we look forward to seeing each of you at this year's KeyTAM conference on February 17th, February 18th, and February 19th, 2021. And you can register at fedbar.org.